Hello, bonjour everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril, I used to be a stem cell researcher and this is why I can tell you about the science behind skincare ingredients. And for today's video, we are going to talk about two brands, which is Fresh and Tata Harper, or Tata Harper, I don't know how you say it in English exactly, but if I'm not mistaken, this is an American brand and I'm going to tell you why I will not buy those two brands. So a common comment that I usually get when I do this type of videos where I basically talk about a brand's awesome product without even trying them is that, well, you didn't try them and when I tried them, they are very efficient or they did some good on my skin. In general, even formula that are not that well formulated will suit most skin type. Even, I mean, the Nivea cream, for example, that does contain a lot of derivative of essential oils, they can do a very great job, especially on a drier skin type, if you don't have any sensitivity toward the problematic ingredient. And this also is going to happen with those brands. But if I am here putting myself on YouTube and also in Instagram, is to give you better advice and also show you what exists in the market and what is much better than another one, and especially for the price point, but also simply for the quality of the overall formula, because even though those products, I'm pretty sure they are going to work, and I can tell you why they will, there are so much better alternative in the market that will transform your skin even better and make your overall skin looks so much healthier and better looking overall. Also, the main problem with those two brands that I'm going to talk about, and also with lots of brands in the market, is that they do not contain toxic ingredients, but they contain problematic ingredients. And by problematic, I mean ingredients that are likely to sensitize your skin and also trigger skin allergies. And therefore, they are not also for everyone. And even though you may tolerate those products, if you start to incorporate an active in your routine, such as retinol, but it also could be tretinoid, any form of acid, in those circumstances, because the stratum corneum will be thinner, those products can, again, inflame your skin furthermore. Another thing that I want to tell you before I start diving into those two brands is simply about the ingredient sourcing. When you have a brand and you decide, for example, to make a moisturizer, you have a plethora of options to choose from. So as a quick reminder, every moisturizer should contain humectant to attract water. In most of the cases, it is glycerin, which is an excellent one, and then some type of emollient to lock in the water. Basically, that's it. And of course, in the humectant department and also in the emollient department, there are plenty and plenty of options. So a brand can either go with what they like to call a natural ingredient, which I really dislike because by the term natural, it triggers your mind by thinking, oh, if it is natural, it is far more better than something else, which is absolutely not the case. From time to time, natural ingredients, they are the opposite. They are more irritating than man-made ingredients, such as silicone, for example. So when a brand decides to formulate a product, they have a choice in terms of the ingredient that they are going to choose. Either they go straight away with what the different manufacturers will basically claim about those ingredients, or they can go straight away to where the science is, so basically the research article, to see if this ingredient has any legit science behind it to know if it does something on the skin or not. Because obviously, if you're a supplier and, for example, you like to sell plant-derived ingredient, you are going to claim that your own active derived from this plant. So for example, you will see Tata Harper use safflower oleosome. So I have found the manufacturer. So they have a lot of claim about it. One of them is that it is better to control transepidermal water loss compared to mineral oil, which is probably unlikely, but this is just from the manufacturer. Now, if you go to look at the science behind it, there are almost nothing. So you have to put your trust on the manufacturer. And in my opinion, it is far more better to just first of all, look at the science evidence, and if there is sufficient science evidence, you then go and choose the supplier of the ingredient that you want to integrate. But don't put like all, I would say, your money only on ingredients with absolutely no scientific evidence behind them, especially if they are at super high price. So first, let's start with fresh. So fresh has been created in the early 90s. It is a brand that also surf into this so-called natural vibe. So if you go to the website and you read about their philosophy, they claim that by combining potent natural ingredients, ancient rituals and modern science, fresh creates beauty products that perform with experiences that transform. And I'm going to show you some example of what they have, and at the end we will come back to this philosophy, and you will see that most of the ingredients does not even align with their philosophy. So first I'm going to start with their cleansers. So if you're not new to my channel, or if you're new, please consider to subscribe to my channel. You will know that I mostly recommend double cleansing in the evening by using an oil or a balm followed by a water-based cleanser. And Fresh does have an oil cleansers. So this is the Seaberry Skin Nutrition Cleansing Oil that retail for $43 for 150 ml. So it is a little bit expensive, but I mean, not that much. So if we look at the ingredients, you will see that this one has some grapeseed oil. You also have hydrogenated polyisobutene, which is an alternative to mineral oil. It is a good ingredient like to remove like the makeup and of course the sunscreen. So I mean, I'm not mad at it. Then you have a fire, and this is going to help the oil to rinse. I had a very interesting comment in my first cleanser video that you should definitely check. And one of my subscribers asked me, but why we don't use straight away cooking oil? And obviously cooking oil is also going to remove everything from your skin, but the problem is that they don't have emulsifier, and therefore when you will try to rinse it, it won't, because oil doesn't mix with water, and therefore your second cleanser, the water-based cleanser, will not be able to remove all this oil, because on this channel I only recommend gentle and acidic based cleanser. So this is why it's better to use a dedicated cleansing oil. Anyway, we also have Caprylic succinate triglyceride, which I'm also fine about it. We have camelia seed oil, it is also not bad. We have hypopharae rhamnoids oil, nigella sativa seed oil, and etc. So, I mean, a lot of extract. At the end of the formula, we have not so good ingredients. We have fragrance, which might be allergenic, of course. And then we have also limonene and linalool and citral. So those ones are also fragrant component derived from essential oils. And now they are required to be listed outside of the list of what we call fragrance or perfume, simply because they are known to be very allergenic. So having perfume and even essential oils in a first cleanser, or even in a second cleanser, in a water-based cleanser, I'm not really mad about it, because for most people, we are not sensitive to perfume. I am not sensitive to perfume. I am also not sensitive to most essential oils. Therefore, because it is not a leave-on product that you are going to rinse anyway, it is not a great dealer. What I always find, I would say, a waste of money is to have all those different ingredients, all those different blend of oils that obviously cost more money, but they are not going to do anything on your face, because you are going to rinse those this cleansing oil. So again, I prefer to have a more basic, straightforward formula as a first cleanser. Obviously, if you have, if you don't care about it, you can definitely try it. A good alternative that is definitely more affordable is simply this one from DHC, DHC. So this is a Japanese brand. This is the Deep Cleansing Oil. Another favorite of mine is simply the Adalabo, the cleansing oil that is also super affordable. In terms of second cleanser, they have one that is very, very famous, which is the soy cleanser. So this one retails for $38 for 150 ml. So it is a little bit pricey, but I mean, not that much, that's fine. So this one is not overly bad, I have to say. So the second ingredient is cocoa glucoside, which is a very, very gentle detergent. Then we have a bunch of different oil, like soybean oil, sunflower seed oil, borage seed oil. So in this one, it's not overly bad, I have to say. The main detergent is cocoa glucoside. And then we find a bunch of different oils in the form of soybean oil, sunflower seed oil, borage seed oil. We also have different extracts. We have our water from roses. Some of those extracts are fragrance, so I am not a big fan of them. There is also extract from soybean sterols, an extract from ginseng, again an oil from roses, which is basically an essential oil to give the fragrance. So again, not a big fan of it, but like I said, it is not a leave-on product, so it's not going to kill your skin. So I've never tried this one. If the concentration of oil is very low, it may be a good one to try. But because the main detergent is cocoa glucoside, this is a very, very gentle one. I am a bit worried that this one doesn't cleanse the skin, or it has a very, very low detergent effect, I would say, on the skin. And this is still important to have a cleanser that really cleanse. Two other alternatives that are so much better is this one from Crave Beauty. I have raved about this one so many times. This is the Matcha Hemp Hydrating Cleanser from Crave Beauty. This one, if I'm not mistaken, retails for $20. So, and the overall formula is way better than the one from Fresh. Another alternative is the French one, the Avène, the Extremely Gentle Cleanser Lotion. Again, I have talked about this one a lot of time on my channel. Both of them are also fragrance free and they're also cheaper than this one. If you want more recommendation, check my videos on my favorite second cleanser. I have plenty of options. And I have also an option that is in the same price point as the French one, but the overall formula is way better. In order to have a proper cleansing routine, a key essential step is of course to have some form of exfoliators. So the best one are, of course, the acid in the form of AHA, alpha hydroxy acid, or I should say NBHA, beta hydroxy acid. So glycolic acid is an excellent one. Lactic acid also, especially for more mature skin. Alpha lipoic acid is such a good one. I have a whole video about this one. Azelaic acid also. And in this brand, there's I didn't see any product containing acid, but what they have is a scrub. So again, I'm like, not really interesting. Also, the scrubs are a bit expensive for what they are. I'm not 100% against scrubs. I do think that in certain circumstances, especially when you have a lot of acne and you are under a dermatology treatment, a very gentle scrub would be better than an acid, because you would need something that is gentler on the skin. But overall and in general, I do prefer to recommend an acid that is fragrance free. In terms of toners, they have one, which is the Rose Toner, that retails for $45 for 250 ml. The overall formula is, again, it contains perfume. You also have two extracts of essential oils, citronella and also geraniol. Which again, it is not optimal, especially in a toner. You have just cleansed your skin, so your skin is more vulnerable. So you do not want to have a first layer with perfume. It doesn't really make sense, and I find it a bit silly. You also have the essential oil from Rose, again a potential irritant. So what makes this toner hydrating is, of course, the glycerin. Nothing new over here. You also have the butylene glycol, and basically that's it. So it is pretty because it has those rose petals in it, but overall, this is a no for me, and I will not spend $45 for a formula like this. If you want a better alternative, try this one, the I'm From The Rice Toner. An excellent one, very simple, fragrance-free. Again, for the price point, this one is so much better and it's also cheaper. Another alternative is my beloved Cocoa Gin Lotion from Adelabo that contains three forms of hyaluronic acid. In terms of moisturizers, I'm just going to talk about two. So the first one is the Rose and Hyaluronic Acid Deep Hydration Moisturizer that retails for $42. Again, the overall formula is very... not interesting. I mean, it has those irritants again in the form of perfume. You also have the citronella and the geranium. So, I mean, overall, I'm like, there's also again the rose essential. Also, I believe that this one smells like roses. I mean, hence the name. So, the first humectant is glycerin, something that is very, very common but excellent. Then you have an emollient, the ethyl exhyl isonoate. Again, you have butylene glycol, pentylene glycol, and propanediol. So the three are also humectant. Most of the time, butylene glycol is used in skincare to dilute other actives and components of a face cream. But in this cream, this is basically what you got for $42. So it's not very interesting. You also have a bunch of botanical extracts. Again, with the botanical extracts, you either have some of them that do have lots of scientific evidence to show that they work and that are not sensitizing to the skin. I'm thinking, of course, about Centella Asiatica. Check my video about the CKBio line from Bioderma that use Centella Asiatica. This line is excellent. Purito, also the unscented one, like the their sunscreen, for example, is also an excellent one that use Centella Asiatica. So those botanical extracts, they have basically almost no scientific data. So you have to believe, I would say, the brand that they work, and you also need to cross your finger that they are not going to irritate your skin. So again, it's a no-no. So the other moisturizer that I want to talk about is the Lotus Anti-Aging Daily Moisturizer that you sell for $48. So this one, use an extract from Lotus or Lotus. This is the Nelumbo Nucifera extract. So there are some studies that show that it is indeed anti-aging. Is it the state of the art of anti-aging ingredient? Absolutely not. If a brand choose to make a face cream or a serum that doesn't choose the state of the art ingredients, which is basically retinal deiodine over the counter skincare, I do prefer to have a variety of different anti-aging ingredients, which is not what we have again here. Again, the formula is problematic because we have an essential oils from lemon, which is the citrus lemon peel oil. Again, at the end, we have limonene, also a derivative of citrusy essential oil. We also have citral is also a notorious ingredient to trigger allergic reaction, and overall the formula is again not very interesting. The choice of emollient is really not that interesting. If you are looking for better alternative for an outstanding moisturizer that is not too expensive and that retails around $20, try this one from Curel. I have a whole video dedicated to Curel. So this one is the Intensive Moisturizer Cream, and this one is simply amazing. And the main emollient in this one is a pseudoceramide, so a molecule that is very close to the lipid that we already have in our skin, in what we call the epidermal lipid. So this formula is way better, and also it doesn't contain any irritants. So if we go back to the beginning, so fresh said that they combine potent natural ingredients. This statement is not true at all, because most of the botanical ingredients that they use, because I don't like the word natural, so I'm going to use botanical or plant extract, they don't have that much of science behind them. So basically you need to believe, I would say, the brand and all the suppliers that supplies those so-called plant-derived ingredients. Ancient rituals, I mean, why not? I don't know them. Modern science, absolutely not. You don't find any new actives in this one. This is very, very old school. You don't find any encapsulation technology, or at least they don't talk about it. You don't find any antioxidant, especially in the form of vitamin C, for example, vitamin E, ferulic acid. It also could be resveratrol. I mean, there are plenty and plenty of options. So again, this statement is 100% untrue. Fresh creates beauty products that perform with experience that transform. I do believe that the products are pleasant to use. because I have swatched some of them while I was in Sephora, so the texture is pleasant. I do find that the perfume of some of them are way too strong to my liking, and again, you are taking a risk when you are using those cream loaded with perfume. You don't have also any retinol, any acid, so this is definitely not the type of skincare that I go for. So now let's move on to Tata Harper. So this one is also a little bit in the same, I would say, philosophy, in the sense that they use what they call natural ingredient. Again, so by natural, they mean plant-derived ingredient. And definitely with Tata Harper, is more, or this is at least what they believe. In my opinion, this is the total opposite, especially how their formula are created. So it is a very, very expensive brand where you are not going to find any state-of-the-art ingredient that have a ton and a ton of research to show that they really works on the skin. You also don't find any innovative technology in those formula. You do have oleozone from safflower oil. So again, I tried to go online to see if there is some legit scientific evidence to show that they are better than safflower oil, for example. Well, apparently this is not the case, so again, you need to trust the manufacturer. So like I said, the price point is crazy. It's very, very expensive. Most of the product retail for at least $100 or more, so crazy point. And it is loaded with different botanical extract, and some of them are very, very well known to be allergenic. So the first product that I want to talk about is an essence. So this is the Hydrating Floral Essence. So again, ton of plant-derived ingredients. So you have an extract from Odium, Vulgari leaf juice. I tried to find any scientific evidence on the skin. I didn't find any. There are some scientific evidence in model like carcinogenic sunlight and so on. In melanoma maybe, but I might be mistaken. But applied totally on the skin, we basically have nothing. Then we have the first problematic ingredient, which is neroli distillate. So most of the time, all those distillate, flower, water, and etc. does have fragrance component. Fragrance component, they can enter the skin. And what happens is that your body can recognize those molecules as what we call antigen, and your body will react to them. So this is basically an allergic reaction. Even though your body does not react to them, we cannot exclude the fact that they do enter under the skin barrier into our cells, and that they are going to do some damage at a low level that we cannot see it by the eyes. And this is very problematic with those type of formula because there are a ton of fragrance component and botanical ingredients. So you have lavender flower oil, again problematic ingredient, rosa damasca flower water, so again rose water, leuconostoc ferment filtrate. There are not much scientific data on this one. Sodium hyaluronate, that's a good one. And again, other botanical ingredient. What I found a little bit sad is that you only find at the end glycerin, which would have been excellent to have it on the top of the formula to really like a lot attract the moisture in your skin, so the water, and also hydrolyzed cornstarch, so it's basically sugar. This one also would have been way better to be on the top of the formula and not at the end. Would have paid $64 for this formula? Absolutely not. So in terms of serum, so they only have to my knowledge one product, that is an exfoliator that supposedly use AHA and BHA. This is at least how it is sold. You will see that when you look at the formula, I'm like, where are the AHA and the BHA? Mm-hmm. So the beginning of the formula is similar to the essence. So you have the same extracts from Hordeum vulgari leaf juice. Then we have propanidol, which is in the same, I would say, family as butylene glycol. So this is an humectant that helps to solubilize other ingredients. Not mad at it. Again, a plant extract. Then you have glycerin, which is fine. Another plant extract. Then we have oobacil oils, qualan. So we have oils. So again, if you are using an acid, you do not want to have an oil with it because the AHA are only soluble in water and not in oil. And therefore, if you are using a serum that contains an oil, the AHA will be less efficient. So this really makes no sense. And then we find finally one AHA in the form of lactic acid. So I do like lactic acid. It is an excellent one. This is also a natural AHA that occurs in our skin. You find it in the dead skin that we name corneocyte. They are participating to our own natural moisturizing factor. So I really like this, but I don't like the fact that it is combined with all those botanical extra that might be problematic, and especially with an acid. When you're using an acid, you are basically thinning out your skin barrier, so you are helping all those problematic ingredients to really like go deeper into your skin. So of course you do not want this. And then again, when you go through the formula, tons and tons of botanical extract with basically no science to back up the claim. You have an extract of a lemon, and at the end you have a bunch of junk. So you have mica. Mica is fine, but this is a common ingredient in makeup. I'm like, this is a serum, especially an AHA, supposedly an AHA based serum. Why put mica? It is just to make you think that your skin looks better, but it is just from the mica. So basically this is makeup, this is not reality. Then we find dyes. We also from citral, limonene, linalool, geraniol, and benzoyl benzoate. So all of them, plus all the botanical extract, they are excellent to trigger sensitivity and of course an allergic reaction. So no, no, and no. Then this is when it is even worse, because if you look at the Elixir Vitae, this one retails for 403 euros. Like what? For 30 ml only with 72 ingredients. I mean, this is insane, especially when you think that for this price you pay for almost 72 ingredients that are only botanical extract with no scientific evidence. I'm like, what the hell? So for this one I am only going to give you the problematic ingredients. So you have the rose flower water. It could be a rose flower water that is not fragrant, like the one that is used in The Ordinary, the glycolic toner. You also have an extract from orange, and at the end again we find citral, citronellol, eugenol, geraniol, limonene, linalool, and etc. And a bunch of different oil and excellent. Overall, I do find that this formula doesn't make sense at all, especially for this price. This elixir, like they like to name it, is supposed to be anti-aging. You don't have any single ingredient with proper science behind it. Would you pay 400 euros for a bunch of ingredients that have absolutely no scientific evidence, plus a lot of problematic ingredients? I mean, in my book, it is a huge no-no. In terms of moisturizer, it is also the same one. The one that I'm going to show you is the Illuminating Moisturizer. For 50 ml, it retails for 100 euros. So again, a lot of money. So the first ingredient is aloe vera leaf juice. So this one is an excellent ingredient that also has humectant and that does have for once scientific evidence. Then you have water, you have shea butter, ethyl ester, excellent one. Safflower, oleosum, I've already talked about in the beginning of this video. There is no proper science behind them, but apparently those oleosum should be better than safflower oil, and mineral oil to reduce transepidermal water loss. I am of course not sure about this, but I mean, why not? Those ingredients are not problematic. Then we have caprylic triglycerol, excellent one, very common one. This ingredient, you also find it in the Ordinary, the natural moisturizing factor. I have a whole video where I review this formula that is way better than this one. Can you imagine this? And it is, and it retails for less than 10 euros or dollars. Insane. Then we have mango seed butter. We finally have glycerin. So here it is my problem. So I would expect that the aloe vera leaf juice is really concentrated in humectants, but I cannot be sure of it. I would prefer to have the glycerin a little bit higher in the list of ingredients, but anyway. Then we have olive oil, jojoba oil, that is a bit better. And then the rest, a bunch of different botanical extract, no scientific evidence, and the same fragrance, Here it is mentioned as aroma, citral, citronal, adenal, geraniol, linal. I mean, a lot of ingredients that are very problematic. So I do believe that those products really smells very good. Probably also the texture is very well. Of course, if you don't have impair skin barrier and not sensitivity, those type of products can definitely work and you will feel very luxurious because of course you have paid a ton of money for the cream. But now, if you try to incorporate them into a proper routine, simply even this moisturizer with a good AHA and a good retinoid, you might put yourself in a risk of developing an allergic reaction and overall sensitizing your skin. And finally, we have this oil. I'm going to describe this oil, the retinoic nutrient face oil. I wanted to put this one out there because retinoic, for me, ring the bell of retinoic acid, which is also known as tretinoin. So when I saw this name, I was like, what? So maybe it does contain a retinoid. Well, it does not. So it retails for 118.47 euros. A lot of money, again, for 30 ml. And what you pay for this, you pay for a rosa seed oil. So this one could be okay if it is not the essential oil. It is, if it is from the seed, it is not supposed to be an essential oil, so it's not fragrant, I mean. Then you have olive oil, jojoba seed oil, apricot seed oil, okay? And then immediately you find perfume. Why am I going to pay more than 100 for 1, 2, 3, 4 basically oils and then have perfume? Because perfume in olive oil product, they are restricted to be at 1% or below. Most likely in a skincare, it will be around 0.5 to 0.1. So the rest of the ingredient will be very, very minimum. And what you find at the end, again, are the formula: citral, citronel, eugenol, farnesol, geraniol, limonel, linal. I mean, an insane amount of product that can trigger an allergic reaction. And if you do the old Tata Harper routine, you are really, really putting your skin in danger mode. I strongly discourage you to try one of those products. They are way worse than the one from Fresh. Comment down below and tell me if you want me to do more video like this. Of course, if you like this video, please thumbs up. Consider to subscribe to my channel and don't forget to ring the little bell to not miss any of my new videos. You can also follow me on Instagram. I am Cyril Laurent. I have plenty of stuff here. I thank you so, so much for watching me and I will see you next time. Au revoir everyone. Bye bye.